hard when I'm with you. We're pals, we're buddies through and through. Wish I knew what to buy for you on your birthday. Our friendship goes against the grain. I've seen you swell up in the rain. I saw you, didn't see your pain. Was it termites?
Kevin, have you seen Ed at all?
No, cuz. Last time I saw him was at the burial for Rolf's hen. What's up?
Well, I like seeing that kid. Not seeing his funny faces makes me feel woozy. In disguises, no one knows. Has the face. Who's this?
Dude,
that guy's bad news, Zeke. You know about strangers. Look, I'll be careful. Sir? Do you need anything?
Look, girly boy! When you get in my face like that, you're gonna get your pretty face punched in! Let go!
Back off, you dork!
Zeke and Kevin wrangled a bad one, Plank! Kevin! Be my lord! The son of a shepherd has saved hero Kevin's fallen cousin. Yet you still shed the sorrow that relates well to the loss of great Nano.
What the?
Whoa. Look who showed up in all his Kalitz-style glory. Reference Spring Nicht Don't Jump by Tokio Hotel music video. We'll play that right now, baby. That's just if you're wondering. If you watch the animation, it should be a bit clearer now. This is the high mark, page 50 of this long-run story. Now it all winds down from this part. It's unknown how many more pages I'll be doing since my written form of my spiral notebook is about 80 pages or so. So keep reading.
I'm pregnant.
Where have you been in the last 9 or 10 pages?
The morning Ed boy has returned in the dress of the Dark Knight. Rises.
Thank you for stepping in, Ed.
Duh. Don't thank me, thank Kevin. I do the same thing for my baby sister, Sarah.
Hey! Mm-hmm. Before you call yourself a hero like a snob, I have a little story I should tell you. I'm someone who can see angels and demons, and you are dealing with a demon. I was walking down the lane because I was bored, when I thought I heard whistling or chimes or whatever the heck annoyed me. I peeked through the tiny knothole in the fence, and this bird sat on top of its coop and whistled like it was a human. I looked at it, and when I saw its scarlet eyes, I knew I had to do something. So I jumped over the fence, and I did what I was obligated to do. You, out of all of these kids, should thank me. I could have saved y'all from getting possessed.
Fool! You mutilated the domestic fowl and shall face the son of a shepherd!
Rolf, no!
You still don't believe me? Look in the mirror. You're starting to look like that chick you were with on the cliff.
Away with the young corruptors!
Oh, I'm sorry, Wubs. The bomb had a point, but what Ed shouted moments ago just sealed my suspicion.
Alex looks scary pretty, Double D.
Why are we secluded in Long-Haired Ed Boy's basement dungeon?
I had this thought. Ed draws often, so maybe he's drawn spell recently.
The shy eyes need to see.
Pull my bangs back for me, then. Is this her? I don't remember Ed being this good at drawing. She looks like someone from one of his comic books.
This piece of work is ghostly, like Nana's nightly prayers. Why draw a choker around the neck?
I'm not sure, but I'm definitely taking this to Double D and Alex. They're examining Ed in the garage right now. Maybe he can confirm it after all the tests are done.
That hurts still.
Rolf?
Would candied beets ease your injury, shy eyes?
I'm alright, Rolf. I just wish this craziness would end soon. Nothing makes sense anymore.
I'm going to check Ed's vital signs first, just to rule out any illnesses that are affecting his pulse or brain waves. Unfortunately, this new appearance of his can't be explained yet. His hair isn't one of Eddie's wigs.
Look, smacking you in the face was extreme, so I'm sorry.
Oh, I understand, Alexandra. There's no hard feelings.
So you did deserve it.
Strange. He doesn't wear all black.
Not to mention the nails. Ed's turned into some type of Dracula.
I'm a double Dracula, baby. This is not good.
Let go!
Whoa! Alexandra!
That can't be safe at all.
The Blackbird has stolen this one!
What? I'm not sure.
Double D, I believe this is linked to what we're dealing with.